Hello students, previously we have learned about the weather. We have studied the different weather conditions of a few locations in India according given data which is recorded at the same day and at the same time. We have noted that the weather conditions of these places are different. Such a type of weather conditions can be expressed as a hot, cold, rainy, cloudy, etc. But these weather conditions are short-lived. We can experience these changes in the atmospheric weather conditions prevailing at a place and at a given time. This implies that the weather conditions keeps on changing frequently. Such types of changes in the atmospheric weather conditions can be experienced according to the seasons. And today, we are going to learn about the relation between the seasons and these atmospheric weather conditions and elements of weather. Let us see. And now, take out your textbooks and turn page number 20. Can you tell? Since childhood, you have experienced summers, rainy seasons, and winters. On the basis of your experience, answer the following questions. First question: in which months do summer, the rainy season, and winter occur in a year from January to December? Show it in a chart. Students, the seasons on the surface of the earth occurs due to earth's axial motion and earth's orbital motion. What is the earth's axial motion? Earth rotates on its tilted axis. What is a tilted axis? Look at this figure. The earth's axis is an imaginary line passes through Earth's center from North Pole to South Pole, and this axis is tilted by 23.5 degree. See this geographical axis, and this is a tilted axis. Earth rotates on this tilted axis eastward, that is from west to east. And to complete one rotation on this tilted axis, Earth takes 24 hours. And during these 24 hours, we experience daytime or daylight for 12 hours and night time for 12 hours. This is Earth's axial motion. And now, let us see what is the orbital motion of the Earth. When the Earth rotates on its tilted axis, at the same time, the Earth revolves around the Sun on its elliptical orbit. Look at this Earth's elliptical orbit or path on which the Earth revolves around the Sun. This path of Earth's revolution is elliptical. That means looking like an ellipse. That is why it is called elliptical orbit. And the Earth revolves around the Sun on this elliptical orbit. And to complete one revolution around the Sun, the Earth takes 365.25 days. And this duration of the Earth's revolution around the Sun is called solar year or tropical year or year of seasons. What is a season? A season is a period of the year that is distinguished by special climate conditions.
And what is the climate? The climate is the average weather conditions of a place observed over a long period of time is the climate of that place or region. At a particular period of time, we experience climate changes. These periods of climate changes are called seasons. And since childhood, we experience summers, rainy seasons, and winters. But when we are talking about the seasons on the whole surface of the earth, there are two major types of the seasons, summers and winters. How? Let us see. When the sun travels in the northern hemisphere, that is the area of earth's surface from equator to north pole, in the period from 22nd March to 23rd September, the northern hemisphere faces to the sun. As a result, day duration or daylight duration increases, and due to more heat or energy received from the sun, northern hemisphere experiences summer season. And in the same duration, that is from 22nd March to 23rd September, the southern hemisphere, that is the area of Earth's surface from equator to south pole, keeps far away distance from the sun. As a result, night duration increases, and due to less heat or energy received from the sun, the southern hemisphere experiences winter season. And when the sun travels in the southern hemisphere in the period from 23rd September to 22nd March, the southern hemisphere faces to the sun. As a result, daylight or day duration increases, and due to more heat or energy received from the sun, the southern hemisphere experiences summer season. And in the same duration, that is from 23rd September to 22nd March, the northern hemisphere keeps far away distance from the sun. As a result, night duration increases, and due to less heat or energy received from the sun, the northern hemisphere experiences winter season when it is a summer season in the southern hemisphere. Thus, there are two major types of seasons on the surface of the earth, summers and winters. And what about rainy season? The rainy season is the time of year when most of a region's average annual rainfall occurs. For example, in India, where the seasonal winds known as a monsoon blows from the sea to land in southwest to northeast direction, these winds influence rainfall in the summer season. Due to these winds, India experiences annual rainfall. This period known as a monsoon or rainy season or wet season. This is called summer monsoon. The Indian summer monsoon typically lasts from June to September. And during this period, most of the part of India experiences annual rainfall. And now, let us try to understand the cycle of seasons on the surface of the earth. When the earth revolves around the sun on its elliptical orbit, the northern hemisphere, that is the area of Earth's surface from equator to north pole, faces to sun along with north pole. As a result, this hemisphere receives more sunlight or heat or energy from the sun. The day duration or daylight duration and night duration on the surface of the earth is equal, that is a 12 hours daylight or day duration and 12 hours night duration on 22nd March. It is called vernal equinox. And from 22nd March to 21st June, the daylight duration increases day by day in the northern hemisphere. As a result, due to more heat received from the sun, northern hemisphere experiences spring season, and in the same period, it is from 22nd March to 21st June, the southern hemisphere, that is the area of Earth's surface from equator to south pole, keeps far away distance from the sun. Night duration increases in the southern hemisphere. As a result, due to less heat or energy received from the sun, the southern hemisphere experiences autumn season when it is a spring season in the northern hemisphere. In the northern hemisphere, 21st June is called summer solstice. It is the longest day in the northern hemisphere and the longest night in the southern hemisphere. And in the period from 21st June to 23rd September, the duration of the day in the northern hemisphere decreases. But this hemisphere faces to the sun. As a result, receives more heat or energy from the sun. The northern hemisphere experiences summer season, and in the same period, it is from 21st June to 23rd September, the southern hemisphere keeps far away distance from the sun. As a result, this hemisphere experiences winter season when it is a summer season in the northern hemisphere. And on 23rd September, the day duration and night duration is equal on the surface of the earth. It is called autumnal equinox. From 23rd September to 22nd December, the southern hemisphere faces to the sun. During this period, the day duration or daylight duration in the southern hemisphere increases. As a result, due to more heat or energy received from the sun, the southern hemisphere experiences spring season. And in the same duration, it is from 23rd September to 22nd December, the night duration increases in the northern hemisphere. As a result, this hemisphere experiences autumn season. This is called winter solstice in the northern hemisphere and summer solstice in the southern hemisphere. Because summer season starts in the southern hemisphere and winter season starts in the northern hemisphere. From 22nd December to 22nd March, the day duration or daylight duration decreases in the southern hemisphere, but this hemisphere faces to the sun. As a result, due to more heat or energy received from the sun, the southern hemisphere experiences summer season, and in the same duration, it is from 22nd December to 22nd March, the northern hemisphere keeps far away distance from the sun. Due to this, night duration increases As a result, this hemisphere experiences winter season. Thus, we have noticed that each season lasts for a particular period and each season occurs at a particular time of the year. For example, see this cycle of seasons in India. Season spring occurs from March to June. Climate during this period sunny, and we mainly uses cotton clothes in this season. Next season, summer or monsoon, occurs from June to September. Climate during this period hot and humid and wet. In this season, we mainly uses cotton cloth, raincoat if it is raining. Next season, autumn or retreating monsoon occurs from September to December month. Climate condition in this season, cloudy, hot and cool. We mainly uses light cottons, light woolens in this season. Winter season occurs from December to March. Climate condition during this period, cool and mild sun. We mainly uses woolen clothes in the winter season. This is a cycle of seasons in India. Note down that retreating monsoon is a type of seasonal winds that blows from northeast to southwest in India. This is a period of a transition from hot rainy season to cold winter season. It is marked by clear sky, moist ground, and due to high temperatures, especially in October month, we says October heat. Thus, we have noted that each season lasts for a particular period and each season occurs at a particular time of the year. The scientist observed the weather in a region for many years. With the help of such studies, they define the mean weather conditions. The average weather condition of a place observed over a long period of time is called climate of that region. Climate is generally expressed as cool and dry, hot and humid, hot and dry, etc. The weather changes quite often due to changes in the temperature of air, winds and humidity, etc. We always experience these changes. A sum total of all these elements define weather. These affect our day-to-day activities and lifestyle. For example, we mainly uses cotton clothes if it is a summer season. We uses raincoat if it is raining. We uses woolen clothes if it is a winter season. Such a way. Thus, we have noted the relationship between the atmospheric conditions or weather conditions and seasons on the surface of the earth. The elements of weather can be taken into consideration while describing the climate. Let us see elements of weather.
Let us see elements of weather. First, temperature. The Earth's surface gets heat from the sun. As a result, the surface gets heated up. The air close to the surface starts becoming hot and later one by one different layers of air at a higher elevation receive heat. Therefore, as we move upwards from sea level, the temperature of air decreases.
The temperature also goes on decreasing from the equator to both the poles. Due to spherical shape of the earth and resultant curvature surface of the earth, sun rays occupy larger or lesser area of earth's surface. The equatorial region receives perpendicular sun rays. Therefore, equatorial region experiences high temperature, and as we move from the equator towards the north pole and towards the south pole, due to curvature surface of the earth, this area receives slanting sun rays or very slanting sun rays, and as a result this area of earth's surface experiences low temperature. Thus, as we move towards both the poles, due to curvature surface of the earth, the temperature of the air goes on decreasing.
Next element of a weather, air pressure. Air has weight. As a result, it creates pressure. Anything that has weight exerts pressure on the thing that lies below it. Thus, the air in the atmosphere exerts pressure on the surface of the earth. The lowermost layers of air get subjected to the pressure of the upper layers. Hence, the density of the lower layers of air increases. There is a greater air pressure near the surface of the earth, and it decreases with increasing height. As we move upwards, the air pressure decreases. This is a vertical air pressure. These changes also occur in a horizontal manner. This gives rise to winds.
Next element of a weather, winds. Air starts moving from high pressure areas towards low pressure areas in a horizontal direction. This movement of air is called wind. Wind blows from high to low pressure areas, and its speed depends on the amount of difference in air pressure.
Next element of a weather, moisture. The atmosphere contains vapor. The air that has a greater amount of vapor is called humid air. The humidity in the atmosphere is called moisture. The proportion of moisture in the atmosphere depends on temperature. Air with higher temperature holds a greater amount of moisture. Next element of weather, precipitation. The surface of the earth gets heated up due to heat or energy received from the sun. Due to this heat, water turns into gaseous state in the form of water vapor. This process is called evaporation process. The atmosphere contains water vapor. The air that has a greater amount of water vapor is called humid air. The humidity in the atmosphere is called moisture. This moisture or water vapor in the atmosphere condenses into water droplets or snow particles and forms clouds. Their showering on the surface of the earth is called precipitation. Rain, hail, sleet, snow, these are forms of precipitation. Weather is described on the basis of the conditions prevailing at the given time, while climate is described on the basis of conditions prevailing over a longer period of time. Weather keeps changing frequently, and we can experience these changes easily. Changes in the climate take place over a long period of time. These are not perceived easily. Latitudinal position from equator to both the poles. Height above sea level. Nearness to ocean. Far away distance from ocean. Ocean currents, etc. are the factors that influence climate.
Besides these, mountain ranges, types of land like mountains, plateaus, local winds like a sea breeze, land breeze, etc. are other factors that influence the climate of a region.